where you are?
Oh, yeah. Oh, this is really hard. Kind of crazy. But as long as it, I wanted to go by your stuff so that you don't have to step on. And you guys do, look at that, I love that. You guys do the same jam?
No, not the same, we use different ones.
It's always different. Do you have your little list?
We sure do. I have mine.
I should have mine, but I don't.
Any one of these, you know, basically.
You guys have a, what'd you do last week? We'll do something different.
The one we did last week was F last week. Yeah. That was fun to do, but we could do.
What do you think? I don't care.
This is my favorite, B.
Let's do B.
B it is.
Let's do B.
Four bars of each.
Woke up this morning. Ah, come here, you. Come for that. So I think we'll do Gotta Be second. And we'll do Choose. Hey, look, Steve's there. Steven.
Oh, a video?
Yep. This is first, then that. And then Spirit of God.
And Rob and Darlene shared all the details for you. And I'm going to turn it back over to them. Go back and enjoy.
Where's God is? Oh, it's. Where do we do God is doing something wonderful also?
Yeah, that's right at the end of the service.
Only at the end?
Yeah.
Only closing song.
Good morning, Center for Spiritual Living.
This is first, that's second, that's third.
Thank you.
Are we awake and ready? Are we awake to... If we're not, let's wake up. Woke up this morning with my mind.
Buenos dias. Guten Tag. Calimera. What? Gut, ja. Danke. Ich spreche kein Französisch. Good morning. I know I've been saying that in all kinds of languages. Welcome to the Center for Spiritual Living, Simi Valley. We have loving hearts, open minds. I'm going to challenge that. We'll see. We are a new thought community. What's going on? We've got a tiny wee slide. We got stuff happening. Okay, volunteer of the month. No volunteer of the month. You know, this thing only goes out. I don't have one of those little things so I can hear what they're saying to me from the back, so we're just faking it here. Okay, so after that, Reverend Stevens' video.
Yep,
okay. Because, you know, he can't be here, but he's always here. He's always here in our hearts. And he's on the wall in the lobby. Let's hum. It's Om. I love it. The speakers are with us. They're almost ready.
Are you happy to be here?
I'm happy to be here.
I'm happy to be here.
So, a minister, a rabbi, and a priest walk into a bar, and the bartender looks at him and says, Is this a joke?
Good morning, Center for Spiritual Living, CD Valley. Good morning, Center for Spiritual Living, Simi Valley, coming to you from CSL East, far east, like Charleston, South Carolina. I wanted to be with you this morning because this is the eve of Earth Day, one of my special days of the year to honor our dear Mother Earth. And I thought I would do so with you this morning by sharing a poem from a poet who some have called the modern day Rumi. Her name is Shalon Harkin, and she's written a poem called We Drink the Same Water. It touched me so last night, I decided I would record this and share it with you this morning. We drink the same water the dinosaurs drank, that Muhammad used for his ablutions, that Jesus used to wash his disciples' feet, that our ancestors emerged from to try feet, that our ancestors emerged from to try feet. The same water that crashes in a quintessence of creation's power at the base of Niagara Falls. We drink the same water that has lived inside each other's tears. Some deep part of us has tasted the suffering of all and the tenderness. Our bodies are made of tributaries, oceans, and clouds. We cycle through each other. We are the unconditional baptism of rain. The heavens have always known the whole earth is holy. We are Everest mist. We are the evaporation from the Amazon. We are the atmosphere. We are made of ancient water, and our makeup is continually recycled through the heavens. Our makeup is continually recycled through the heavens. Happy Earth Day, my loved ones. I'm hoping that you will join the Centers for Spiritual Living worldwide in a morning of prayer for our dear mother. And Rob and Darlene have prepared all the details for you. And I'm going to turn it back over to them and go back and enjoy the beautiful, humid weather of Charleston, South Carolina. I'll see you next week. Love you much.
Please hold. If all goes well, there will be a QR code, ta-da, which will take you to the place where you can sign up. And it does say Zoom, but it's not a Zoom meeting. You just sign up to get notice of the Zoom meeting. Is that right, darling? Did I do okay? Yeah, if you do the QR code, then you can sign up, and then they'll send you the link to participate. Okay, we also have the QR code. If you can't catch it here, we also have it on a little placard out there in the lobby. Right. But it's not just prayer, there's also music and some little talks and things. And also, and this is going to be important for the rest of my talk, there are other things going on that are listed on the CSL website that you can go, you can find out about and get involved in. Okay? So whatever kind of thing you're interested in, check it out. So next. Okay. Do we know this one? Okay. Who are we? We're community, inclusive, loving, and authentic. We celebrate all paths to God in gratitude, empowering self and others. We serve compassionately through outreach, inspiration, and education. That's who we are. That's why we're here. And here's what we do.
Good morning. Please join with me now in knowing that there is only one love, one light, one infinite truth. It's right where I am. It's right where each and everyone within the sound of my voice is. Nearer than my breath, closer than hands and feet. And so I know that this love is permeating and penetrating and moving through every space of the universe. And I know that it's moving through me. It's moving through you. It is the truth of who I am and who each and every one that's come to be of service today is as and through the divine presence that they are, making this beautiful day unfold with grace, with ease, with inspiration, with transformation. And so I know that this good is already done in the mind of God. I let it go. I let it be so. And so it is.
So it is.
God is upon me. Oh, Spirit of God is upon me. Oh, Spirit of God is upon me. Oh, Spirit of God is upon me. Oh, youth was between the one, two.
But I think the trickster of Coyote is here as well. So, especially in the front row. So I'm what, right? I'm too late. Too late. So I'm here to remind you, yes, Earth Day is tomorrow. It's a very special day. But I believe that Earth Day should be every day. So, yes. Send our love to this beautiful big blue planet that we all share. And I know we know how to do the three R's: reuse, reduce, and recycle. Woohoo! But there's many more. There's so much more that we can do, right? Even in our own hearts, just to send our love to our planet every day. Every day. No, we can do it. Woohoo! Let's do it. Let's pray together tomorrow, and let's pray together right now. Let's blast off, Cosmic Kids. Let's go.
Okay. So I love to love about love. And so let's love right now this affirmation. Let me say it first and then you join me. I let the love that lives within me go out to the God who lives in and as all people. Together, I let the love that lives within me go out to the God who lives in and as all people. Thank you. So welcome to the journey. Welcome to the journey of love. This is a statement of love from the book, If the Buddha Got Stuck, A Handbook for Change on a Spiritual Path by Charlotte Castle. Welcome to the journey. The purpose of life is to be alive. I'll say that again. The purpose of life is to be alive. Not to gather objects, achieve, accumulate successes, or forge your body into to fit a mold. It's simply to be alive. To touch, feel, sense, hear, see, and live in a dynamic flow of whatever arises in the moment. To accept the wild and crazy thoughts that go through your mind, your animal nature, your wisdom, the fears that arise and grip your chest, the laughter that brings tears, and the joy that takes you beyond yourself. To be alive is to meet and accept every part of yourself, the scuzzy, sweet, passionate, talented, or slow. From this place of self-acceptance, you can be a good friend to yourself and to others. This does not preclude achieving, learning, or taking good care of yourself. But you do so because your body, mind, and energy converge to do whatever feels in harmony with the aliveness that you are. From this point of self-acceptance, our consciousness spills over into the vast expanse of human experience, and we start to see the connections between all sentient life. Between our brothers and sisters and others everywhere. Said another way, we start to experience love.
All right, this next song is coincidentally, or not so much coincidentally as we know, about love. And it's about choosing love, that we sometimes forget, I often forget, that I have a choice to make. It's not just, it just comes, the feeling is there all the time. I get to choose love, and that's what this song is about.
Cannot age you. Fear cannot scare you. Pain cannot hurt you. And death cannot kill you. Choose love. Choose love. War cannot harm you. Hunger can't starve you. Sin cannot shame you, and guilt cannot blame you. Choose love. Choose. And you feel like giving up. Choose love. Money has spent you, and beauty will tempt you. Fame's gonna fool you, and power will rule you. But choose love. Choose love. Choose. Doubting your direction, and you feel like giving up. No, don't, just choose love. Years cannot age you, cannot scare you. Pain cannot hurt you. Even death cannot kill you. We know that. War cannot harm you. Hunger can't starve you. No, sin cannot shame you. And guilt cannot blame you. Choose love. Choose love. Sing with me. Choose love. Choose love. Choose love. Choose love. Choose love.
Thank you, Gary Nicholson. Yeah.
So I invite you now to join me as we move into the God awareness place, that place within in which we commune with the Most High Spirit that's right where we are. Right where the breath is. Right where every organ function, action, and reaction of the body temple is. It's all God. And so now we will begin with a 3-minute silence, allowing you to connect with that God awareness place within you. So I invite you to partake in this deliciousness 3 minutes a day. You can do it. And I invite you to just eat this magnificent God awareness place on a daily basis. Thank you.
All right, this is a song by Desiree, and it's called You Gotta Be. And there are a few things that we gotta be, but we gotta be this. We gotta be spirit. We are. Yeah. Dedicate this to my wife and her family over in Spain and the healing. Love will save the day. Listen as your day unfolds. Challenge what the future holds. Try to keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. Stand up and be counted. Don't be ashamed to cry. You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold, you gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard, you gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm, you gotta stay together. All I know is love will save the day. Herald what your mother said, read the books your father read. Try to solve the puzzles in your own sweet time. Some may have more cash than you. Others take a different view. My, oh. You gotta be, you gotta be bad. You gotta be bold. You gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard. You gotta be tough. You gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool. You gotta be calm. You gotta stay together. All I know is love will save the day. No questions, it goes on without you. Leaving you behind if you can't stand the pace. World keeps on spinning, you can't stop it if you try to. This time it's a danger staring you in the face. Oh, 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 oh. Listen as your day unfolds. Challenge what the future holds. Try and keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. My, oh, love will save the day. Come on. You gotta be bad, you gotta be cool, you gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard, you gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm, you gotta stay together. All I know is love will save the day. Take it away, Steve. Woo! Mm-hmm.
know, all I know is love will save the day. Come on, everybody. You gotta be bad, you gotta be proud, you gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard, you gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm, you gotta stay together. All I know is love will save the day. Come on. You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold, you gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard, you gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm, you gotta stay together. All I know is love will save the day. All I know is love will save the day. With me, everybody. All I know is love will save the day.
Yeah. Don't give my talk away. Y'all prepared to be stronger?
Yes.
Wiser?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah. Why not?
Okay, okay. We'll see how this goes then. And thank you. And love will save the day. Hello, my name is Robert Thompson, he, him. I am privileged to be a minister and practitioner here at this wonderful Center for Spiritual Living, Simi Valley. Reverend Stephen is out this week, so he asked me to cover for him. So I'm the speaker. Yay! So last week he spoke on being a spiritual giant. And this week, Giants is the name of our men's group, and it's an acronym for God in Action, Nurturing Togetherness Spiritually. Yeah. And so this week he was going to talk about sacred sisters, and so I said, I'll do that. So I got the talk title and the affirmation, but the talk is mine. I have no idea what he was going to say, where he was going to go with it. This is all me. So, sacred sisters' purpose. A sacred circle spiritually exploring loving connection for the betterment of the world. So who here is for making the world better? Who here is for making the world better? Who here is in favor of loving connections? Spiritually exploring. Okay. Who is in favor of circles? Who's in favor of squares? Triangles. Triangles. Okay, we got some triangles here. Okay, so let's see, what else I got here? Maybe. Can't read my own writing here. See, I have all kinds of handwritten things on this because, you know, I kept thinking, oh, I gotta say that. Gotta say that. Okay, so who here has been to a Sacred Sisters meeting? Lots of people. Okay, cool. So this morning, though, as was outed already, we are all going to be sacred sisters. For the next little bit, I'm going to try an experiment. In my talk, I'm going to use the word women to speak of all of us. So women is humankind. So some of you may be uncomfortable with that, but here's the thing. Representation matters. Visibility matters. Inclusion matters. Equality matters. Sometimes you have to turn a situation on its head to understand it. So religious science was founded by Ernest Holmes, and people excuse his sexist language by saying he was just a product of his time. But the third sentence, you only get to the third sentence in the Science of Mind textbook where he says, any scientist who refuses to accept intangible values has no adequate basis for the values which he has already discovered. Do you know, who here knows who the first person to be called a scientist? Oh, you don't. Oh, wait, wait, wait. Okay, who was it? What? Do you have something to share with all the class? She forgot. It was Mary Somerville, a woman back in... Yes, that, we're past that. Back in, okay, what year was it?
1834.
Mary Somerville's areas of expertise included math, geology, and astronomy. In fact, some of her observations led to the discovery of the planet Neptune. And William Whewell was a scientific historian who wanted to write a review of her treatise called On the Connection of the Physical Sciences, because she blended everything together. She made everything work together. And until this time, the term used to describe someone who was good in all these different areas was called a man of science. But that didn't work because she was a woman. So Whewell coined the term scientist to describe Somerville using the pattern found in dramatist, apologist, artist, scientist. Okay? Now you know. Well, there's more. There's always more. Okay, here's a quote from Ernest Holmes: with the masculine language replaced with the inclusive feminine. Now remember, womankind means the human race collectively. So, of course, when we say woman, we mean men also. Let's be a little inclusive here, okay? So Ernest Holmes said, to suppose that the creative intelligence of the universe would create woman in bondage and leave her bound would be to dishonor the creative power which we call goddess. To suppose that goddess would make woman as an individual without leaving her to discover herself would be to suppose an impossibility. The seed of freedom must be planted in the inmost being of woman. But, like the prodigal daughter, woman must make the great discovery for herself. So this is one example of taking a hierarchy and turning it upside down. Many people have been marginalized for many reasons: sex, gender, preference, size, color, race, religion, politics, language. And the thing is, if you happen to be in a more socially valued group, you might not even be aware of your privilege. One of the women I follow on Instagram posted this image. So when you do a web search, I say web search because I use DuckDuckGo, when you look for men's safety items, you get visibility gear, hard hat, gloves, steel-toed boots, glasses. So this is all to protect a man at work. But when you do a web search for women's safety items, you get personal alarm, pepper spray, stun gun, drink protector, door locks to protect women from the men. I think that's to get out of your car. So I think men should have that too, personally. Okay, but see, the first time you come across something like this, it's shocking. Okay, the women here are all going, yeah, and some of the men might be going, oh, never thought of that. Okay, so here we are. So we have room for improvement here. Part of the CSL vision is we envision a world that works for all. So our Sacred Sisters goal is the betterment of the world. How do we do that? How do we change the status quo? What does it take to make changes in life? Aeneas Nin said, and the day came when the risk to remain tight in a bud was more painful than the risk it took to blossom. Right? So pain is a motivator because change is risky. One of my spiritual practices is contentment. Ernest Holmes, Byron Katie, Christianity, Buddhism, all advise us to accept things the way they are. Because to go against what is causes suffering. But if the situation, the way it is, the status quo, already causes suffering, that isn't a world that works for all. But if our vision is a world that works for all, and there is suffering, and then that suffering brings discontent. We have all kinds of things to be discontented, uncomfortable about. Endangered species, the unhoused, for-profit prisons, mass shootings, wars, famine, disease, climate change, overpopulation. And when they feel that discontent, it's a call to take action. It's to volunteer for a cause that moves your soul. So I'll take a breath. Because love will save the day. We stronger? Wiser? Okay. I love how it all just works together. So how do we affect change for the betterment of the world? We begin to affect change when we blossom spiritually. One of the catchphrases today is, change your thinking, change your life. It's not just Science of Mind that says that. It's also in Psychology Today and Forbes magazines. It's mainstream. Ernest Holmes says, at any time, we can change our thinking and set in motion new laws which govern our lives. When peace, harmony, and love rule in our thinking, we know they will register in our lives as effect, bringing health, happiness, and prosperity. Holmes also said, in treatment, I'm just going to quote this whole thing, in treatment, we turn entirely away from the condition because as long as we look at it, we cannot overcome it. By thinking upon a condition, we tend to animate it with the life of our thought, and thereby it is perpetuated and magnified. Treatment is the science of inducing within mind, that's capital M mind, the mind of the universe, concepts, acceptances, and realizations of peace, poise, power, plenty, health, happiness, and success, or whatever the particular may be. Treatment is not willing things to happen. It is to provide within ourselves an avenue through which they may happen. Treatment opens up avenues of thought, expands the consciousness, and lets reality through. It clarifies the mentality, removes the obstructions of thought, and it lets in the light. It removes doubt and fear in the realizations of presence of spirit, and it is necessary while we are confronted with obstructions or obstacles. We already live in a perfect universe, but it needs to be seen mentally before it can become a part of our experience. Every problem is primarily mental or spiritual, and the answer to all problems will be found in spiritual realizations. When we treat and move our feet, we pray and volunteer, we can affect real change. The Christian Bible says there is neither Jew nor Gentile, neither slave nor free, nor is there male and female, for you are all one. We are all one. We are all sacred sisters. So today we can expand that and say, there is neither Ukrainian nor Russian. There is neither Israeli nor Palestinian. there is neither Democrat nor Republican. Breathe. Our teachers say that we are to treat and move our feet. So we decide what we want, and when we think about actually having it, present tense, having completed it, we contemplate it. We dream about what is life with it and imagine it already here. Just like Marianne said in her treatment, the purpose of life is to be alive. Actually, you're reading. The purpose of life is to be alive. Because we are biological creatures and we have an imperative to stay alive. And usually for us, that means get a job, find a place to live, go grocery shopping, or fast food, whatever. So the question becomes, how do we stay alive and be in harmony with other people and other species? Today we might say, how do we be socially responsible and reduce our carbon footprint? I'm always talking about asking better questions, because our subconscious looks for answers to the questions that we ask ourselves. How can I make the world a better place for every living thing, from the bacteria in the soil to the giants in the deep blue sea? If we are one with all that is, we can start making connections with others who aren't like us. Each of us is unique. Thinking of womankind, the words I use to describe myself won't be exactly the same words that anyone else uses. How do I connect with others? Sean Jinwright says, we need a fundamental shift in our values, a pivot on how we think, act, work, and connect. So how can I be more loving to my family, to my friends, to my acquaintances, to strangers, to people I disagree with? How do I connect for the betterment of the world? I respect their identity, how they see themselves. That means I address them as how they wish to be addressed. I use their name. I use their pronouns. And I listen to what they have to say. Whether I agree with it or not, that's not the point. But I listen. And as I listen, I try and separate their descriptions of lived experiences from conjecture and rumors about others. Sean Jinwright says that we need to listen to others, and if they share things that are contrary to what we know from our own lived experience or facts from trusted sources, that we respectfully call them out. Thinking about all the suffering in the world, for-profit prisons, mass shootings, wars, climate change, etc., can be very stressful. So here's a wonderful spiritual practice to help with the stress. We've been doing it already. Breathe. Because when we get stressed, we tend to hold our breaths. Breathe. Belly breathe. And as you breathe, consider, how do I feel right now? What am I thinking about? Is there any tension in my body? You just have to notice them. Just acknowledge them. Give them space. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to fix them. You just experience them and let them be. Because over time, they will change. Because there is suffering and trauma in the world. And what can we do about that? We start by taking care of ourselves. Reshma Menachem gives us some techniques in this book, My Grandmother's Hands. Soothe yourself to be quiet, to quiet your mind, calm your heart, and settle your body. So you do this when you feel that there's a conflict and it's beginning to escalate. You start with this, soothe yourself. And simply notice the sensations, vibrations, and emotions in your body instead of reacting to them. Accept the discomfort and notice when it changes instead of trying to flee from it. Stay present and in your body as you move through the unfolding experience with all its ambiguity and uncertainty, and respond from the best parts of yourself. And then, when you're in a safe place, safely discharge any energy that remains. Hitting a pillow, going for a walk, jumping rope, something like that, something physical. Menachem also lists practices that we can do in community, some of which we do here already. Singing together, group drumming, rhythmic group clapping, humming in sync with others, hugging people mindfully. Can we all agree that peace is a better state than war?
Yes.
Yes. Oh, we got some big yeses. We can be the peacemakers for the betterment of the world. However, before we go too quickly, peace without justice is tyranny. So I'm going to read you something that was written in 1922, and I've updated the language to use womankind to mean the human race, which of course also includes men, as well as a couple other phrases. So this is from To an Anxious Friend by William Allen White. You tell me that the law is above freedom of speech. Because, you know, there's that whole cancel culture thing going on, right? You tell me that the law is above freedom of speech. And I reply that you can have no wise laws nor free enforcement of wise laws unless there is free expression of the wisdom of the people and, alas, their folly with it. But if there is freedom, folly will die of its own poison, and the wisdom will survive. This is the history of the human race. It is the proof of women's kinship with goddess. You say that freedom of speech is not for times of stress, and I reply that the sad truth is, it is only in time of stress that freedom of speech is in danger. No one questions the calm days because it is not needed. And the reverse is true also. Only when free speech is suppressed is it needed. And when it is needed, it is most vital to justice. Peace is good. But if you are interested in peace through force, without full discussion, which is to say, free speech, decently and in order, your interest in justice is slight, and peace without justice is tyranny, no matter how you sugarcoat it with expediency. This state today is in more danger from suppression than from violence, because in the end, suppression leads to violence. Violence indeed is the child of suppression. Whoever pleads for justice helps to keep the peace, and whoever tramples upon the plea for justice, temperately made in the name of peace, only outrages peace, kills something fine in the hearts of women, which God has put there when we got our womanhood. When that is killed, brute meets brute on each side of the line. So, dear friend, put fear out of your heart. This nation will survive. This state will prosper. The orderly business of life will go forward if only women can speak in whatever way given to them that they say in their hearts, by voice, by postcard, by letter, or by press. Reason has never failed women. Only force and repression have made wrecks in the world. So we are a sacred circle, spiritually exploring loving connection for the betterment of the world. Woman is the architect of her own life. Science of mind gives her the tools to build it. community, treatment, meditation, and affirmations. So, say this affirmation with me. I let the love that lives within me go out to the God who lives in and as all people. So we know that treatment is fueled by the energy of our emotions. So let's change the emotions in the room. So a priest, I think I already said this one, a priest, a rabbi, and a minister walk into a bar. You're still laughing. And the bartender says, is this a joke? Okay. Well, that's a different thing. So a priest, a minister, and a rabbi were arguing about who is the best at their job. So they decided the toughest client would be a bear. So they go out to the woods, and first they send out the priest, and he goes out, and he finds a bear, and he converts, and he comes back and says, I found a bear, I converted it, it's now Catholic. And then the minister goes out, and he finds a bear. No, this one's a man. His pronouns are he, him. The rabbi, however. Oh, yes, it will. See, I tried him out on her. Okay, so now the minister is going out to convert the bear. And he goes out, finds the bear, baptizes it. Now I have a new convert. Comes back and says, yes, I successfully converted the bear. So now the rabbi goes out. She goes out into the woods to find a bear. And then she comes back, and she's cut, and she's bruised. And I said, what happened? And she said, maybe I shouldn't have started with the circumcision. I love how the energy has changed. That's what makes it funny. Okay. So I've asked David to lead us in some rhythmic clapping and humming. So, So now that we're settled and our spirits have been lifted, let's go into our revealing prayer. Because what we know is that there is only the divine, God and Goddess, lover and the beloved. And each is both, and each is all. We are all sacred sisters here. Because there's only two kinds of people in the world, mothers and children. And there is a divinity that has given birth to everything around us. The planet, the air, everything. Everything is divine. We are divine. And we know that as we treat, as we move our feet, we affect real change in the world. We volunteer where our hearts call us. That we see that there is suffering. And we attend to it. We heal it. We comfort it. And we take care of ourselves. We are community. Authentic and loving. Open-minded. And we take care of each other. We join together in community and support each other for the betterment of the world. So I know that the truth is that back behind everything is everything we need. There is a substance that has no form until we give it. So we think about what we want. What do we want? We want peace and justice, health, prosperity, not just for ourselves, but for everyone. Right relationships, food on the table, a place to live. And we know that all of these needs are fulfilled for ourselves, and we go out to spread the goodness. Because we are the eyes and ears and the hands and the feet of the divine. And we are so grateful for this recognition to remember who we are. We're so grateful for this teaching, for all of our teachers, for all of the wise folk in the world. And from this place of gratitude, we release this law to mind, and in the mind of the divine it is done, and we accept this, we do this as we say, and so it is. Thank you.
I'm okay. I have a plan. Don't worry.
Okay. This is taking care of church business. Thank you. Oh, you guys. You gals. All us chickens.
This is a beautiful, beautiful man. And thank you. Wow, our hearts are open. We are so filled with love. Thank you, Reverend Rob.
My pleasure. So we got some more church business to attend to. So we know that this place operates on two things. Volunteers and cold hard cash. However we get it. So the ways that we can get it are visit the website, text the word give, or call the office. there's breeze, call the office, drop a check in the basket, cash in the basket, whatever you want. And we affirm our prosperity for ourselves and the community by saying, divine love is doing its perfect work here and now. Divine love harmonizes. Divine love adjusts. Divine love prospers. Divine love foresees everything and richly provides every good thing for the world, Center for Spiritual Living, Simi Valley, and me now. Divine love prevails. We have some tinkling under the slides.
And so how grateful I am to know that we are so blessed, so absolutely blessed with this abundance, this visible flow that is right here, right now, pouring forth. And it's pouring forth through these baskets as well as through the digital airwaves, through the YouTube links, through all of the opportunities that each and every one has to give and be abundantly prospered in the receiving. For as this blessing is blessing this center, I know it is blessing and multiplying prosperity for all that give. It's with a grateful heart that I give thanks, and so it is.
So it is.
Good to be here. Thank you so much. Okay, so that was just a warm-up, you know, before that little clapping, humming thing, right? Because I like to get you guys singing and to integrate and to speak and make into affirmations that you can take with you some of the things that you heard today. So there was a lot. This is a challenge to try and figure out all of it. But some of the things that I heard were sacred sisters. So we got to have that. We got to have that. And I think what I would love to hear, the front row here, and you're bounded with two male sisters. Sacred sisters, sacred sisters, sacred sister, nice to sacred sisters, say, keep going. Over here, we've got, we are women, we are women, we are women, we are women. I see everybody saying that we are women from this broad perspective. We are women. If anybody doesn't feel like they can quite say that yet, they can say, we are human, but we're going to go with we are sentient. We are women. We are women.
Everybody.
We are women. In the back, can I hear? For the betterment of the world. For the betterment of the world. For the betterment of the world. Let's stand. For the betterment of the world. Women. We are women. We are women. For the betterment of the world. Now just take that in. Use your voice. Reclaim your voice. Allow the power that flows through you to give power to these words, to make them true for you. Hold those pitches. Hold those things. Sacred sister, sake of the world, for the betterment of the world. For the betterment of the world. We are women. 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 Nice and slow. We are women. We are women. We are women. We are women. And so it is.
So thank you, everybody. Thank you to all of you for participating in this whole thing we have going on here. Our lead service was Greg and Pat Schaefer. Service team, Linda Moore. Signs and stage, Glenn Buckley. Live stream video, Greg, Colin, and Olivia D. Our slide operator, John Mizialko. Musical guest, David Joyce. Backed by the Soul Purpose Band. Steve Fowler, Bob Townley, Randy Jones, Cassandra Murillo. Sound operator, Tony Golf. Cosmic Kids, Cindy Joy and Tracy Carburn. Office, Reverend Nancy Fuller. Fellowship, Lena Townley. Come on. Where is she? And our practitioner of the day, Mariane Giblin. And Ellen and Reverend Nancy, last Friday's drum circle. let's see. And now, okay, so we have the tickets and the cleaning crew. Add the cleaning crew. She's on it. Okay. So this is the last day for the early bird sale for those. And we also have coming up next week, yes, the Spirit Awards, which is the B. Thompson Make a Difference Award. So we send the money to specially selected charities that share our CSL mission and put it to work for the betterment, there's that word again, of humankind. The Virginia Nelson Community Service Award, given to a person who serves the community at large and beyond. The Founders Award, given to a person who serves the center above and beyond. And our Volunteer of the Year, who will it be? Or outstanding team participation throughout the year. What else we got? Are you available for prayer?
I am available for prayer. 1 minute miracles back there. There is also a prayer box. It's blue and it's in the lobby, and you are free to make a prayer request in writing, and the E-team, the ecclesiastical team, will pray throughout the week for you. And don't leave without acknowledging the value of having a practitioner work with you on a one-on-one basis. It is something that does not happen here in the 1 Minute Miracles, but can happen for you to clear away hidden beliefs that are holding you back and fortify you to move into another dimension of living that beautiful life that we've been blessed with. Namaste.
Namaste. Okay. Let's all stand and say our benediction. I'm at home in the heart of God. My life is anchored in truth. I can never be separate. I live in the consciousness of peace. I release all fear. I am living love.
God is doing something wonderful as you and me.
God is doing something wonderful as me. God is doing something wonderful. Glory, God is doing something wonderful, incredible and awesome. God is doing something wonderful as me. God is doing something wonderful as me. God is doing something wonderful as me. Something awesome and incredible, she will get the glory. God is doing something wonderful, incredible and awesome. God is doing something wonderful as me. God is doing something wonderful as me.
It's dancing.
God is doing something wonderful as me. Something awesome and incredible, only it will get the glory. God is doing something wonderful, available and awesome. God is doing something wonderful.
Your tears.
Go ahead, release your fears. Stand up and be counted. Don't be ashamed to cry. You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold, you gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard, you gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm, you gotta stay together. All I know is love will save the day. Herald what your mother said, read the books your father read. Try to solve the bubbles in your own sweet time. Some may have more cash than you, others take a different view. My, oh, oh, love will save the day. You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold, you gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard, you gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. We'll go to your soul blue, you gotta be calm, you gotta be together. All I know, all I know. Guitar solo on letter F. You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold, you gotta be stronger. You gotta be hard, you gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm, you gotta stay together. All I know is love will save the day. All I know. All I know is love will save the day. Last time! All I know is love will save the day. Yeah! Okay, great, super. Fun.
I didn't have a chance to try to practice for that.
You so rocked.
Thank you so much.
That was awesome. And love will save the day. And here's love.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Hello. I mean, oh my God. I love hearing that. I'm like, I knew that as soon as I heard that. I'm like, oh, I love that one.
Yeah, it's a great one.
Close-ups, but I mean, that was so
thank you so much.